On this unforgettable, death-defying episode of the NES Pursuit.
I think I'm actually finding things for the first time in, like, four episodes.
The crew plunges into day two of the Game On Expo. Riff sets a budget for his Master System obsession.
I'm kind of wanting to spend, like, $15 on one game.
Will NESComplex and Riff ever settle their differences when it comes to game hunting?
Because you're just recycling the same stuff from episode to episode. That's what I'm seeing.
Ricky is feeling extra nostalgic and journeys into the land of VHS.
It's nothing for a promotional Super Nintendo Donkey Kong VHS.
Iretrogamer joins the battle and gets his hands on some marquees. Will bundle deals work with these items?
Tyler.
What
Tyler,
will I do?
Tyler.
When one game hunter takes a break, be careful. Another one will swoop the deal.
You want to know the real reason I want it? Huh. So that he won't have it.
So he can't have it, yeah.
And prepare for a crushing travesty. You don't want to miss what will be remembered as the most devastating chapter of NES Pursuit history.
I run back to where the slip and slide was. They're like, what do you mean? Dude, he's hurt. When Riff says he's hurt, he's hurt.
Stay tuned. The NES Pursuit starts now.
Day two here at Game On Expo in Arizona. We got our good night's sleep.
Since try out the new watch, but it really doesn't tell time. Chanel thinks it's useless.
Don't hide.
So it's day two. I'm excited because there was a lot of things I did not get to pick up yesterday that I'm hoping I'll get a deal on today.
Good morning. How about healthy?
We're heading back into the convention. Who knows what's in store? We have no idea.
Are you filming right now?
Let's go in there. See how the pursuit plays out at day two. You want to get his life savings? He's got $22 in there.
That's a whole lot of money.
So we are here in the convention, and I myself, as always, yes, say it all you want. So right off the bat, we're in here again. What I want to do, I need some Sega Master System stuff. A $15 or less good Sega Master System game. I'm not that knowledgeable. I'm more nostalgic for Sega Master System, but I'm going to need help. I'm going to go to the one man who knows Sega best. My favorite, sorry, other Sega channels, my favorite Iretrogamer. I see him over there. Let's go. Hey. A guy named Tyler from Iretrogamer.
So I'm there just browsing, doing my morning rounds.
Uh-oh, who's here?
Ah! And here comes Riff. He just comes right up to me like,
what's up,
man? Out of nowhere. I'm like, oh, what are you doing here? What's going on?
My goal right now is to get a Sega Master System game, a decent one, for $15 or less. I need your help. Tyler, I need your help. Find me a game.
Okay, I can help you. I definitely want to help my buddy out. I want to help this guy out. I want to make sure that his Sega Master System collection improves and grows.
Right away, he starts, come with me. Do you smell it?
This way.
Really? We start sniffing the air. He smells it. I follow him.
Uh-oh.
Usually my sniffer's working, and sure enough, it leads me right to this vendor who's got some really nice condition Sega Master System games.
And right away, he just pokes. There it is. He pulls out, blink, Rambo, First Blood, Part 2.
Rambo's a great game. It was known as Secret Command in the UK.
I have a lot of nostalgia attached to this game, but in a terrible way. I was always watching my brothers play the game. I never actually got to play the game. I saw them experienced it through them. So I'm wanting this game, but the game is $20.
Listen, if you can't get it for me for $15, I don't care.
So Tyler, I'm like, hey, listen, tell me, is this worth it? Is this good? He opens it, he looks at it, he's like, this is minty. This is beautiful.
Oh, it
is. And it's complete.
And it looks clean. It looks mint. It's got even got the catalog inside it, the 1986 catalog.
And look at that, it's got a 1986 Ooh. Game catalog.
But something I learned right away, Tyler knows his Sega.
It is minty, my friend.
That's not helping you get it for $15.
No, it's not, you're right.
Maybe, I don't know, maybe it's because I don't do a lot of game hunting and I don't do a lot of pickup videos. I'm not a game hunter like these guys are, like you guys are.
He's saying out loud, this game's minty. This is a clean copy. This is a game. I'm like, Tyler, shh. You don't tell the seller that.
And Riff's looking at me like, dude, come on, man. What are you doing, man? I'm trying to make a deal here.
And he's like, what's a good bargaining? My bargaining technique is to smile, put a camera in their face, and say, will you take this price?
This is how I do it. I just ask. I don't resource. Heck, sometimes I don't look at prices.
We collect ourselves. We're like, it's okay. He goes, let me show you how it's done. Let me show you how to do it.
Would you do 15 on this?
Yes, I will.
Ooh. This is a good man right here.
So we asked for 15. The guy accepted it right away.
And in mint condition, in such good condition, like for $15, it's so worth it. And I'm like, dude, you just scored. You just scored big time.
Dude, I ducky with Spider-Man.
Hey. How you doing?
Whoa, that's a little too LA for me.
So you guys watch this show, you've seen the episodes, you know how it goes. Riff is always telling me I don't buy things.
Blah, 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 like he does, never knowing what to buy. He never ends up buying much.
But you know what the truth is? I do buy things. I buy things for him because he's always trying to borrow money, begging and borrowing.
I'm gonna have to borrow more money from Chris until we get to that ATM.
You think about it, we're at this swap meet. He's like, can I borrow a couple bucks? And then he buys something with my money.
I've borrowed money from Chris like twice at the same swap meet. It's not like I'm always borrowing money from him at different places throughout the game hunting time zone.
Can I borrow a few more dollars? More, buying with my money.
How much is this?
I was doing 20 on 15. We'll do 15 on it.
Here we are again. We're standing at this table and we see this DuckTales thermos. And of course, Riff grabs it. He's like, all right, I've been, you know, I'm into lunchboxes lately for some reason. He's gonna be drinking out of this a lot.
I'm seeing if there's any milk left.
He needs
left
a sippy cup. And he's like, I gotta get this DuckTales thermos. But sure enough, what does he say? Can I borrow some money?
Hey, it's 15 bucks though. Can I borrow 15 bucks for real?
Do you have to borrow money?
Yeah.
It's to work on his brain because that is a delusional thought he has in his brain that I do that.
Look at this. He has to borrow money. You should be bringing money. Are you serious? You should be bringing money if you plan on buying things. Wow. He's always calling me out like I don't spend money. He spends money, but he spends my money. It's like $15. Actually, it was marked $20. He wants me to just give him $20, and yet I don't buy anything. Gosh, that guy.
Wait, what did you say about me?
Refill needs some money?
You're so good looking.
Thank you.
I love you.
You know I love you.
Hang on. The NES Pursuit. We'll be right back.
So we head over to this booth, and they have these VHS tapes.
Take it right out of my hands.
No, so I can, then you're gonna put
I will not make you look bad. I would not do
They're promotional VHSs. They're beautiful, great shape.
Yeah. I'll take that too.
Too late.
Guy comes over, $5 each. I'm like, all right, I think I can deal with that. $5 is, it's nothing.
Great, good job, Ricky.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Mira. Mira, él no es la única persona que puede hablar español. Yo también, ¿eh?
Where's Donald Trump when you need him?
Oh, my God. Y yo también.
So I knew Riff was going to be here, and I was like, man, I want to give this guy something. I've known Riff for years. He's my friend. We've talked so many times. And this was the first time I was actually going to meet Riff in the flesh. And so
Tyler's like, come with me. I have a gift to give you. And I'm like, uh-oh, what is it? Gifts are always just, is it a prank gift? Is it a silly gift? Is it a serious gift? So he takes me over to his booth.
Riff, I know, man, that you've been looking for Master System games. I mean, that's... I want to give him something that would be meaningful, not just some random Master System game, you know. So cool. I love you, buddy, and I have some.
I'm nervous and thankful and scared all at once. And he gives me a boxed, nice copy, which that's not even what matters, but Altered Beast on the Sega Master System.
God.
All right, let me say this right now.
Because we worked on a video on Altered Beast before. We talk about Altered Beast all the time.
Him and I have talked about Altered Beast too many times together.
Yep.
And this is actually a pretty important gift because this is like my most desired Sega Master System game.
Different things.
It's kind of like our go-to
talk. It goes like 5 years back, probably, something
this
like that.
Is,
yeah, about 5 years.
I would say the game on the Master System that's not worth the most, but to me, worth the most, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah. And it was just, it was awesome. It was awesome seeing him, because I knew he wanted it. I knew he needed that in his collection. It's not a rare game.
Dude, thank you so much. Oh, it even has the manual in there too. So this was a good gift, a wonderful gift, a gift I don't deserve. Oh, this is fantastic. Thank you so much, but I'm thankful for.
It's actually more meaningful for me to give something like that than you know, something that's super rare. Also doesn't hurt the pocketbook either.
Power up! I'm awkward. And I, dude, thank you so much.
Totally, man. It was awesome.
Ricky sucks.
I'm a floating spider beast.
I'm very disturbed, though, that both of these are in the case wrong. This one's upside down, and that one's backwards. So then, you know me, I love Super Nintendo, and I see some Super Nintendo games on the table, and I'm eyeing through it, and I see ActRaiser 2, which I've been looking for, and Alien 3. So I think I'm actually finding things for the first time in like four episodes. And then I see Darkwing Duck for the NES, which I used to have, and I had done a video about it, but I needed to get these things in my collection. But I guess if you're gonna find things, you're gonna find things at a place like this where they have everything, right?
He's so smart. He says all the right things, and I want to be just like him one day.
So I'm adding it up, and I total it up, it's $80. All right, so we got 45, 25, 10. I don't want to spend $80. I mean, that's we don't want to spend what people actually ask, right? We got to wheel and deal and negotiate and bargain. All right, I'm interested in these three. I want the bundle, if I can get the bundle deal. Come on, please, hook me up. So, I offer 70. Yeah, so there's $70. You'll do 70. Right. Thank you so much. Which basically means I got Alien 3 for nothing, for free. So I feel pretty good about that deal. And now I got three more games in the NES Complex collection.
Look at me! I'm buying something.
I thought you were going to say we can arm wrestle. No.
Yeah. We can do that.
So I'm on the pursuit. I'm on the pursuit with my buddies.
The next booth we go to is this lady. She has marquees and like arcade stuff.
Ricky, I have to find something first.
Okay, how sick is this? This is for the actual like buttons and joysticks.
And it's $5?
Looking at the booth, you wouldn't even know that she did. She's got like little plushies here and there.
We're at this vendor, and Ricky and I, we're both like eyeing these arcade marquees.
We go and we start going through these, I guess marquee paper, I don't know what it is. That was a...
Actually, he has a soft skin.
And we're flipping through them almost like you'd flip through vinyl at a record store.
There was this Aero Fighter one, and you know what? Aero Fighters is so good, and this thing's so clean.
And sure enough, one catches my eye.
and it's the real Ghostbusters. Now, it's an off-brand marquee. It's not the original marquee that was in the original cabinet. It's one of these off-brand ones that they would make and put in arcades, but, which is pretty obscure. You never see it. It was a top-down action kind of shooter, almost like the top-down segments in Contra, but with the real Ghostbusters. It was awesome.
But at the same time, Tyler wanted to pick, I think it was a Ghostbusters one.
Tyler.
What
Tyler,
will I do? Tyler. So I'm like, I really want this, but it's kind of too expensive. For an off-brand marquee, it's got a sticker spot on it. It's got some wear here and there. I'm like,
real Ghostbusters.
You want to end up like Chris on the NesPursuit, or we just talk trash while he doesn't
buy stuff? Oh man.
Look at me, I'm buying something.
So Ricky and I, we kind of like, you know, maybe if we both go in together.
Weird, you know, kind of burn-in, you got like stickers and
that just sounds like more nostalgic to me.
That makes it more OG.
Yeah, it kind of does make it more OG. Yeah. Maybe she'll come down. So
let's see how the bargaining pursues.
He literally grabbed both. His was supposed to be 10, mine's 5. He went both for 10.
So do you want to get that one, Ricky? Arrow Fighters? I'm interested in this one. Would you do?
So we turn to her, very nice lady. Just say, hey, man, would you do 2 for $10?
2 for $10?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
That'll work. That works.
Hurt your price.
There we go. Deal done. And real Ghostbusters is mine.
His was 10, so he haggled a little. I'm surprised. Tyler, good job.
That was for me.
How was that kiss?
Awesome.
It was like a beard touching a beard, but very softly.
That's disgusting.
Right after this commercial break, a new NES game will be revealed. You don't want to miss it. The travesty is coming. Don't go anywhere.
With the Game Chasers and some other YouTubers in the booth area. A fan of the show
stops and says, hey, I have something to trade or maybe give Ricky or see what we can do. So I'll get Ricky.
Riff is the one that calls me over. He's like, hey, come here. I'm like, dude, calm down.
The guys go, here you go, Ricky, look at this. They break out.
I have a Street Fighter sushi set.
Oh.
With the
dude,
chopsticks.
That's hilarious.
Some really, really cool Street Fighter like dishware sushi chopstick set, and I'm like,
yeah. I didn't have a big use for it, but I started watching your channel. I'm like, oh, you love Street Fighter.
And I'm not gonna lie, they're pretty cool. He's like, dude, you want it? We can make you make a trade or make me an offer.
So you got your little bowl for your soy sauce and your wasabi.
This is something Ricky's really gonna want. He has to want to love this.
And then you got the tray for all your sushi rolls. Holy cow. It's just a weird item.
But I think Ricky's too nice, and I think Ricky only heard like the word trade or purchase, so he probably didn't know what to offer to trade.
I had no idea if you'd be interested in for a trade or whatever, or if you just wanted
it. I always feel bad offering people, especially fans, like, I don't want to lowball a fan ever, so I'm always hesitant. I'm like,
so I, the cheap person, from behind the camera, I'm like,
I'm gonna throw him a $5 bill if you don't offer him something.
I'll give you $5.
Let's switch. Ready? 1, 2, switch.
Riff's like, dude, I don't mind. $5.
You wanna know the real reason I want it? Huh. So that he won't have it.
So he can't have it, yeah.
I showed my wife and his wife, and they're both like, wow, this is awesome.
Hey, it's $5 I can use to spend today. So.
If you'll do it for $5, I'll give you $5.
I got no use for it, so I'll give it to you for $5.
Well, Ricky's still, don't let him pretend. If he does a narration, he's pretending that he doesn't want it. He wants it.
That's the way it played out. I'm good, though. It's okay.
I know Ricky. It's a lie.
It is cool. I'll give that to Riff. It is pretty cool. But it's no N64 watch.
I'll take it for $10 if you No refunds.
Ah!
One of the best ever NES cover. Ever.
We see our buddy John Riggs, and he's been telling me I have something for you, a gift for you.
What?
John texts me.
Yes.
That he had something to give me. We go over, and we got the gift of all gifts.
What? Oh.
I feel like I need some sort of initiation. A real life video game 8-bit version of our silly little show. This is the kind of stuff.
What?
Oh, look, I like this. It has like the little Pixel Game Squad lightly embossed on the back. Like, imagine being in your own video game as a kid. And truth be told, I'd rather be in an 8-bit pixelated video game than some new gen high res. My nostalgia lies strictly in these type. When I was a kid, that's what I dreamed about, looking like a Mario sprite.
Okay, so the game is, you can play as either Riff or Ricky, but you control both at the same time, mirrored. You have to get through the maze.
Oh, that's dope.
And if one gets tangled up in a pile of Nintendo cords, the other one has to rescue them. And how you finish the level is you both have to meet up at the Nintendo game at the very end and grab it at the same time. It's teamwork.
Game. Woo! So this, John, thank you. I appreciate it. We both appreciate it. Coolest thing ever.
Hey, dude.
We made it.
It is a gift as a welcome back to YouTube.
We miss you so much.
Oh, you see guys, save him. Shoot him. There you go.
Oh
he's got to get him. Save him again. Oh,
yeah, it's okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
For real.
No.
Thank you.
Well, and thank you for the years of entertainment, and thank you for the return.
We got given the coolest thing you could ever be given.
Hit me up on YouTube as well. John Riggs on YouTube. I'm on Twitter at John Blue Riggs.
So.
I was walking around and I see the table of Ian. And the first thing that I see, he got a very, very rare PS4 controller.
I got it.
What about this?
Also, I spot he has a very, very rare Wii game, the Dragon Slayer. And that's a treasure.
Well, let me see if I got the money.
And also, he gave me a very, very good price. So, hype! Hi.
Show me
the monies. Way. The monies.
The monies.
The monies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. Hi.
That's the way. What?
I don't eat sushi. My legs hurt.
Chris, go look through there and I'll take your picture.
So, we're walking back to the hotel and Riff says, just hold on a second, I have some things I want to give you.
I have two things for you, sir.
No.
Yes.
So he opens up his backpack and inside he pulls out, like the heavens are opening but light is shooting out of his backpack and he says,
first, I give him the NES.
And it's a shirt for the NES Pursuit.
Pursuit! NES Complex is officially locked in the Pixel Game Squad, because let's be real, at this point he is 100% a part of the NES Pursuit as well.
I think it's a little bit kind of propaganda, self-promotion. Nah, he's just a great guy.
You're not gonna believe this.
I don't believe it.
No, I picked this up for you at the Expo.
It. Then I see he's like, no, but that's not it, there's more.
This.
Oh, holy cow. It's Home Alone. It's Home Alone. You know, there's the whole Kevin McAllister situation where I didn't buy Kevin McAllister, which I do regret, by the way.
But you know what's funny? I don't think he ever says holy cow.
I don't think he says holy cow either. So he bought this, which is great. So I'm going to get to put that behind me, and it says holy cow for some reason on it.
You know, out of all of our Kevin McAllister love in that one episode, I thought you needed to have it.
Was it $5?
Room. Two.
Thank you so much, Riff. You know I love you.
You Riff. Geez.
Hey, geez. Hey, oh no! I date him.
This is it. Right after this commercial, hearts and body parts will break.
So
So, you know, anytime we're out filming, we're always looking for things that would be fun and good shots. And I see there you have all these kids playing in these bubbles, and I'm like, that is perfect.
Right before we get to lunch, we come across this like kid area. It's really cool thing. There's like foam bubbles and there's like slides and everything.
And we're having a fun time playing around with the bubbles.
Riff's like, hey, let's go do something. Right when I hear him say, I'm going in the bubbles, I knew he was gonna do something.
Come here. Feel it. And then I decided I'm gonna go throw some bubbles on Ricky. And I'm like,
You understand one thing about Riff. If Riff gets you with bubbles, he's not just gonna get you, he's gonna shove them up your nose and be like, yo, good.
Wee, Ricky. And I see him go like this.
Literally goes like this, and I knew it was coming, so I'm like, oh.
Sorry, I had to.
I'm gonna get him back. I run over, go like this, I couldn't scoop up enough bubbles, so I'm like, scooped up enough, I start running. And the next thing I see Riff do is like, jump back. I felt bad because he hit that power pole, whatever that was, pretty hard. Like, even I heard it. I'm like, dude, he's hurt.
I dove back as hard as I could right into a meter pedestal.
When Riff says he's hurt, he's hurt.
Well, that's the way something goes. Right into my ribs, and at first I was like, God, that's the way the pursuit, whatever, and I kind of walked away to play it like it didn't hurt. It killed.
I would never want him to get hurt. Let's just say it like that.
I couldn't sleep last night because it hurt so bad. I, truth be told, think that I'm gonna have to go to the doctor for it when I get back because I can't lay out straight, I can't sneeze, it hurts to inhale.
The next thing I notice after lunch is my watch is gone. I was wearing my brand new N64 watch. I was looking around, I was like, I look at the guys, I'm like, dude, my watch is gone. They're like, what do you mean?
He bought an N64 watch in the previous episode.
I run back to where the slip and slide was, no watch. And I go back to the hotel room, I started thinking, I'm like, where could that watch be? Then I thought, remember when Riff tried to get me with those bubbles? And I blocked it. I'm like, oh my gosh. Riff, grab the camera and play that footage. We watched that footage 4 to 5 times.
Dang it.
We re-watched it. My watch was there. It's bizarre because it looks like the bubbles like consumed it and then it just disappeared.
Dang it. And it flew off. And it was gone.
He was jealous of that watch. And now none of us have it because I went everywhere looking for it. Went to Lost and Found.
That's the way Ricky goes. Hey.
This N64 watch, we were told was a promotional watch for the N64. We looked online, we couldn't find anything about it. The guy that sold it to us couldn't find anything about it.
I'm actually pretty bummed though. That watch was, I had to wear it because I was so excited about it. I shouldn't have worn it.
So it's kind of a cool piece to have and we to this day don't know where the watch is.
Thanks, Riff.
I don't want to ramble. I went to the doctor's yesterday and I have a broken rib. Ricky officially broke my rib. It might be payback for all the slaps, but that's the way the pursuit plays out. Oh well, what the frick?
Besides a broken rib and a lost watch, we had a fantastic time once again at the Game On Expo. This is a place we will be returning to every single year as we already have been doing. Thank you guys so much for watching. We really do appreciate it. And make sure to stay tuned for next week because as always, we got another NES Pursuit coming. Thanks for watching.
I'm gonna get you!
Regret not getting a Street Fighter sushi stick thingy.
If it was $5, I would have done it. But
that's what I needed to hear.
But
you won't believe what Riff gave Conklin.
You won't believe your eyes.
Chris is a good guy.
I feel so bad.
And we always look right at the camera for this.
Yeah, yeah. And Ricky's son coming in?
January 29th.
Come on now.
I'm like someone actually knows me.
I would rather him give me $20.
All right.
So I.
Hey, Ricky.
Hey. Oh!